Hey everyone, today's video is about Ihetsu. Please don't forget to subscribe, like, and share. Let's get going!
Bakugo's brows were furrowed, and his mouth twitched into a skull. His hands began to sweat. Little sparks flew out of his hands. As he watched you talk with Midoriya, your hand on his shoulder as you pointed towards his notebook as the two of you talked to each other.
Deku.
He growled as he walked towards the two of you.
You pushed Midoriya behind you as Bakugo stalked towards you too. Surprisingly, his hand didn't shoot out to blow Midoriya up, but rather he reached over and grabbed your arm, yanking you away with him. You showed Midoriya a nod, letting him know you were okay, as you quickened your pace so you were walking next to him, his hand still grasping your arm. When the two of you arrived outside, he pushed you forward, scowling as he crossed his arms. You said nothing as you pressed your hands against your shirt, trying to smooth out the wrinkles. As you waited for Bakugo to speak, sometimes it takes some time to think of the correct words to use.
Why the hell were you speaking to Deku?
He glared at you, his arms folded as he stayed in place. You stared at him for a moment. That's how he was going to start us.
Midoriya and I were talking about one of the newer heroes that recently.
So now you and that nerd are the best friends, right?
He laughed as he stepped forwards, taking the few steps it takes to stand in front of you. He was obviously pissed.
Katsuki, you need to calm down. Midoriya isn't a bad kid. Why are you always so?
He raised his hands, sparks flying out as he moved closer, getting more aggressive.
What? Is that loser better than me?
He was in your face now, his eyes gleaming with hatred as you huffed, getting annoyed with his stubbornness.
Bakugo, you're not listening.
Both of you go to hell. You just walk around, flirting with anyone you see. That seriously pisses me off.
Katsuki, never just being petty and dumb.
As soon as the words left your mouth, a hand slapped you across the cheek. It was hard, and you could feel your cheek burning. You weren't sure if it was because his slap was so hard or if it was because of the sparks that were coming out of his hand. Either way, it hurt like a bitch. It was the first time he hit you. Your eyes widened in surprise as he lifted your hand to rest on your cheek. It took him a moment to realize what happened and to realize what he had done.
Wan.
His voice was small as he brushed past him. Your eyes not looking at him as your hand fell down to your side. You didn't care what you had to say. You needed space. As you walked back towards the school, you saw Kirishima who grinned, raising his hand to wave at you. However, when he saw your face, he stopped, quickly walking over to you as he gently placed his hand on your shoulder.
What happened? You look like you've been hit.
He stops, thinking about how Bakugo did drag you out of the classroom. Did Bakugo hit you? His words were filled with surprise, his free hand rising to caress your swollen cheek.
Don't worry about it. I've got it handled. I'm going inside.
He was past him, eager to get inside where your other friends were. You just needed people who weren't in this mix. Bakugo realizes quickly that this isn't going to be an easy fix. You haven't spoken to him for at least a week. It feels longer. He wanted to ask Kirishima for help. But when the boy stared at him for a moment before looking away, saying how he was on your side and he better fix this quickly, he knew he made a big mistake. He certainly made it hard for him to get you alone. You were always with at least two people.
Fine then, if you're going to be difficult.
Wan!
Bakugo yells your name from across the schoolyard. You stop talking with your friend, turned to look at him, looking him up and down before looking back towards your friend, and you two began talking again.
I'm sorry.
That certainly got your attention. You turn your head again, looking at him once again, staring at him. You wanted him to say something else. You wanted him to say more.
Fine.
Wan, I'm sorry. I made a mistake. A huge one. And I suck.
Do you forgive me?
He asks. as he takes a step forward. Your friends stare at you, waiting for your action. You nod towards them, mumbling something before walking towards him. "Keep going," you say as you stare at him. "I fucked up. I hate you, and I regret it the moment it happened. There is no excuse I can make that will change that. I fucked up, Wayan. And I'm so sorry. Please forgive me." You nod your hand, thinking for a moment. "I forgive you." You smile at him. He lets out a long, relieved sigh. You reached up, grabbing hold of his tie, before yanking down. "But I swear, if you do that again, you'll be in the infirmary for a week." He pulled away, helping him fix his tie, before taking a step back. He said nothing, as he wordlessly followed you out of the school, like a lost dog, too shocked to say anything.
Thank you guys for listening. Hope you liked the video. Please don't forget to subscribe, like, and share.